Here's an example of a UML state chart that illustrates several other features of Harel's notation. Once again, there are three outermost states: idle, maintenance, and active, and the active state itself has nested states inside of it. There are transitions from idle to the boundary of active, two transitions there, and as we saw similarly, each of those transitions is going to go to the default state in the internal machine, which is labeled validating. Another thing to note here is that two of the transitions in the nested machine, in the active state, are labeled with text inside of square brackets. These are data conditions. They are tests, logical expressions on the attributes of the object which is being represented by this particular state machine. In the transition between processing and printing, on the right-hand side of the active state, there are square brackets, and inside it says not continue. Okay, continue is an attribute, presumably a Boolean attribute, and if it's false, then the transition can take place. Otherwise, it won't take place. Also, between processing and selecting, there's a transition labeled continue, which will take place if the continue attribute happens to be true. The other thing to notice about this particular example is that in the bottom on the left of the active state, there are two lines of text, one labeled entry and one labeled exit. These are actions that will take place upon respectively entry and exit from the inner state machine. That is, when a transition from idle goes to active, before anything else happens, the read card action will be executed. Likewise, upon exit from the printing state, when all the other work is done, the eject card action will take place.